I mean, you can make $70,000 a year talking about the Smurfs. That's here's what really is the shift. Nobody can wrap their head around, traditional people that have been in business for a long time, whether personal brands or products, can't wrap their head around the fact that they don't control the message of the brand anymore. Ali, your fans control the message.
Right.
They're the ones talking about it, and the way you respond to them is the game, not what you tell them.
So what does that mean? Does that mean that the idea is you're listening as much as you're feeding out there?
No, the idea is you're listening all the time. You listen. That's the game. Everybody wants to talk. But it's about listening, it's about caring, and most of all, you have to have the chops. If I didn't know anything about wine, it wouldn't matter if I knew how to leverage all this, because when they watched a show or two, they're like, that guy's full of crap.
So you've got to leverage
something you're good at. And that's what you know and you love and what you're good
at. And
that's
where it gets really interesting. If you're working a 9-to-5 and really where the book's going is, you know, those after hours, start talking about gardening, or if you love, you know, curling, I don't know, whatever your passion is, talk about that, live in the communities that talk about it, use search.twitter to find people talking about it, and really get in there.
And one thing we know is these niche, all this technology brings all of the niche people together so that you find that there might be just a few people who like what you like,
but you can find them, and you can have a conversation.
There are millions of people out there that love the Smurfs.
Right.
I mean, you can make $70,000 a year talking about the Smurfs. That's the world we live in, Ali. That's the world we live in, my man. So, I mean, to me, that's fascinating and exciting.
But the reality is here, you are talking, whether it's Smurfs or it's wine or it's gardening or it's curling, you're talking about things that are hobbies that are that may not have paid you anything in the past, but that you can now find an interested group. I'm still, make the connection for
I'll
me
make
to
the
how
connection.
I make money on this.
If I am talking about cereal, and I review cereal every single day, and 45,000 people a day start watching that because the content is good, it's silly, it's interesting, it goes viral, well, let me promise you something. If you don't think every cereal producer in the world is going to start sending you emails, I get emails now from every glass maker, from bottled, I'm getting offered thousands of dollars a week to put a bottled water on my table, product placement. Everything that's relevant in movies and television is relevant online, because if you can get the eyeballs, and the only way you can do that is to have a lot of passion and chops for that subject matter. But even cereal, somebody's going to want to monetize.